breit, sehr breit.
Jetzt ist das ist der Ausschnitt. Der Ausschnitt ist viereckig.
Yeah,
Genau.
good
Genau.
morning.
Ah, good morning. How are you?
Are you? Yeah, I'm sorry. Maybe I didn't explain very well, so the time difference. So.
Yeah. So we are waiting for 1 hour here, but it's okay. It's worse for the colleague in New York because she has to be up the whole night.
That's interesting. Dr. Friedrich, actually we as a journalist I will try to use our talk part of your response at the news story if you don't mind. Is that okay?
Today?
Yeah.
So, but we concentrate on the questions that we talked about.
Yes.
Okay.
Das auch noch mal ausgeschickt.
Ich habe übrigens dieses Grußwort in Englisch gemacht, das war großer Scheiß für das, für den Nationalfeiertag. Wir hatten es gesagt, dass ich es in Englisch machen soll.
Die Botschaft hatte das gefehlt.
Die anderen haben alle in Deutsch gemacht. Normalerweise würde ich mich weigern, als deutscher Politiker in Englisch zu reden. Aber also das machen wir das nächste Mal nicht mehr.
Okay.
Das nächste Mal müssen wir es klären. Die anderen, selbst das Auswärtige Amt, hat natürlich in Deutsch gemacht. Also das ist ein bisschen peinlich, aber.
Okay, schreibe ich mir auf.
Also in der Brexit-Sprache da Großbritannien zu sprechen, ist schwierig. Na, brauchst du nicht notieren, brauchst du einfach merken. Im Zweifel
Ja,
Deutsch.
keine Frage, sondern ein Ausrufezeichen. Noch zu dem taiwanesischen Pass. Das Problem ist, dass eben diese junge Generation, die talentiert ist, in die internationalen Organisationen gehen könnte, keinen Pass kriegt.
Okay.
Und das ist etwas, das vielleicht der Regierung so nicht klar ist.
Keinen
Diese
chinesischen Pass kriegt.
also entweder bräuchten sie einen chinesischen Pass, um in die internationalen Organisationen zu gehen, aber so sind sie mit ihrem Status quasi wie staatenlos. Also weil die UN Taiwan ja nicht anerkennt, deshalb
Und
kommen sie nicht.
warum geben die Chinesen, aber würde denn die taiwanesische Regierung es akzeptieren, wenn sie,
Das habe ich eben die Freundin gefragt, ob sie überhaupt versucht hat. Und sie meinte, rechtlich darf sie keinen Mainland-Pass
sie
behalten.
darf keinen Mainland.
Und deshalb steckt sie in diesem Vakuum
Interesting,
quasi.
interesting, interesting.
Und das ist eben, sind eben diese Einzelschicksale, die man, ja, naja, fand ich interessant, als sie das gesagt hat. So, das ist der Gruppenchat, auf den alle zurückgreifen können.
Hallo, hallo, Vadim Sklerov, Student. Na, deswegen müssen wir es auch später machen, damit die Studenten auch aufgewacht sind.
Wobei Russland wahrscheinlich noch mit Zeitzone
Ja, die haben schon
riskiert.
Mittagessen.
Ja, wenn der Vladivostok sitzt oder so.
Na gut, dann will ich später mal. Da kann ich ja noch mal Pipi machen. Und
Danke
sonst?
dir.
走吧，我下次接你啊。
好，
嗯、
你可以亲姐接我。
嗯。
I think the requirement to wear a face mask on public transport and public areas, and when you're moving around at my local restaurant, I think that is very clearly easily understood. Then, of course, you do have in local areas where you've got particular local circumstances the need to have some of those more targeted local lockdowns. And I know a lot can be made about the differences between the approach of different parts of the country, but broadly, those areas have a lockdown, all have one thing in common. That is, they're telling people not to mix between two households, to stay within their household wherever they might be.
I think it's interesting, and I really don't. I'm not a fan of it giving any cheap shots at all, but you've seen two front pages today. One with former leader of the opposition, Jeremy Corbyn, dining with more people than six, and then father of our Prime Minister, Sally Johnson, walking into a shop without a face mask. So you say these are really simple rules to understand. The fact is that there are people out there who say they have got or apologising for not adhering to the rules. It's happening, isn't it?
Yes, it does. And look, you have to, I think, understand all of this in the context that the measures we're putting in place in any normal time would be quite extraordinary. And these are emergency measures, and trying to look for them to be fair or consistent or perfect is the wrong question. We hope that all these measures that we're doing will dampen the disease and get us through this winter without having to have a lockdown. Are any of them perfect? Does it need to be tested? Yes. Are any of them perfect? No. But we just
need to. Are they simple or are they complicated? I'm not quite sure what you're saying.
The rule of six, I think, is simple. The requirement to wear a mask when out at night is simple. I know that people make an issue about some of the lockdowns that have happened in other parts of the country, but that's responding to local circumstances. And when it comes to compliance with this, generally what we find is people aren't wearing a face mask. School manager will direct them to public transport sometimes, rejected people from trains. Generally speaking, they've not had to resort to penalties and fines in a few hundred cases, and then that's happened compared with several thousand cases where they've just directed people and people have just been offered to apologise and change their name.
In terms of simplicity then, there is a discussion and report, the I newspaper for one, and BBC has also seen evidence being discussed privately, of a new system, a three-tier system. Tier one, where you have it's about how the restrictions will be applied to different areas. So tier one, where you've got the highest infection rates, tier two, some local restrictions, tier three, the rest of England. Is that going to be?
Well, I think it's letter boy how you describe it in tiers, and I don't know whether that's something that the health department is considering at the moment. It's certainly not something that's been discussed with me at this point, but I know that they're constantly looking to refine this to ensure that people do understand the rules. But I think the more important thing is there are national measures that we all have to follow, and that's broadly the rule of six and wear a face mask. And then there are local circumstances where they need to respond to. And generally, there is a consistency in what these local lockdowns require, which is broadly speaking, stay within your household. But some also have different curfews, for instance, on restaurants. And I guess if we can gather that together in a way that people find that easy to understand, of course, that's welcome. We are dealing here with a pretty extraordinary, difficult situation.
Hello?
Yeah, Dr. Frederick, we are waiting for the other speaker.
I'm just checking out.
Okay.
It works here on my microphone.
Mm-hmm. I'm checking if how can I just talk together, because you can see just the two of us on screen. We'll have three more people to join us.
Can we see how many people are here as a...
So far, we have three. Dr. Schell from California, San Francisco.
Oh, yeah. Hello. Hi. Good morning.
How are you? Good to see you.
Okay. And how many spectators do we have? Can we see this? Really?
Yeah, we are waiting for... Victor Gao from Beijing.
So 6 minus 3. Okay. Good.
We are waiting for Victor Gao from Beijing and Jan Christopher Baron from France.
And what about Shirley? What about Shirley? Is she already in bed?
No, I think she has left. I can't see her.
Because we had a short communication, she said. What happened? It's too
good. Good morning. No, it's a British problem. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a problem to be on an island. So you tend to lose the contact to the other to the rest of the world.
Many people tell me, so now we have LED technology. We don't need to worry about wasting energy now. So we should give up the bridge stand up as early as possible. Yeah.
So Hans-Peter, how do you think the Bundestag is going to turn out on the whole Huawei question?
What question?
Huawei.
Huawei. I don't know, but I do not want to discuss this issue because we have a lot of fighting also within the Bundestag. The foreign politicians are. Totally against Huawei. The economists say, "How can we throw out the best company, those people who are the best in the world?" And Huawei is very innovative. They are very successful, and most of the digitalization specialists in Germany say we need them. To make our G5 net in Germany. So I don't know what happens now.
Yeah.
Angela Merkel is very stable in this question, and also our Minister for Economics, but the foreign ministers and foreign minister and the foreign politicians are, well, divided.
Yeah. Yeah, well, everybody's confronting these divides, which actually is the subject of our discussion tonight. So,
yeah. But look, I was always fighting for open markets, for level playing field, and when you say to the Chinese, please give us the opportunity to come onto your markets. We must allow them to come into our markets. So it's a strange discussion.
Yeah.
And we should fight against all kind of protectionism.
Well, you know, having spent my whole life being for open markets and fighting against protectionism, I do feel that things are changing in a way which is going to make it very, very difficult to maintain those.
I agree totally. Because look, those open markets, this globalization is a fundament of all the welfare in the world.
Yeah.
And when we go back to former centuries, it will be a big mistake, and it will be a disadvantage, especially for the poor countries like Africa and so on, because welfare is to be we have to generate welfare all over the world in a globalized world, and so I feel sorry about this development.
I think the real question is whether China can accommodate really open markets and some other open things too that go with them, which are necessary. And that's uncertain. That's what changes the whole equation for us.
Well, but I think China now is in a situation where they are leading in many technologies, and they can afford to open their markets for the European and American companies. And we have to convince them. And on the other hand, we have to show that our markets remain open for the future.
Well, I think we've been doing that over the last few decades. The question is, can they open their markets quickly enough before each of the countries, such as Germany, the United States, Britain, et cetera, make their big decisions? Once the switches get thrown, it's very hard to throw the switch back again.
But I do not think that these decisions depend on the question, is there an open market in China or not? But it's only a political question.
Yeah.
So, for example, the whole discussion on decoupling is only a political question.
Well, there is a security. I think, at least for the United States, we have more of a national security question too, because I mean we have Seventh Fleet, we have allies, et cetera. Germany doesn't have those security issues that we have in the United States. So we have a slightly different kind of challenge.
Sure. And of course, I see the responsibility of the United States for the whole global policy. So it might be a slight different point of view than we have in Europe.
Well, God willing, at some point the United States will be able to take up the mantle of wise leadership again. We certainly aren't excelling in at the moment.
But we don't talk about elections in.
Well, you don't talk about it. I know you watch the debates, though.
In the middle of the campaign, it's. I mean, it's interesting. It's a big issue also in Germany.
Yeah. Well, listen. You've had your last century